My name is Dr. Matthew Boyce. I'm a movement disorder neurologist, and I work with Dr. K. Singh Sani, who is a neurosurgeon, and together we have a very comprehensive team of physicians and practitioners, nurses, anesthesiologists, and physicists who are involved in our treatment programs. We are able to provide multiple treatment options for the symptom of tremor, including deep brain stimulation and gamma knife. One of those treatment options is a procedure called MRI-guided focused ultrasound. The advantage of high-frequency ultrasound as a treatment for tremors is that it doesn't involve any incisions on the skin, so people think of surgery as having an incision, but this is incisionless surgery. Instead of using scalpels and knives, we're using energy. The energy from sound waves sent from multiple directions to a very defined area in the brain, which we target with an MRI scanner. And in fact, the procedure is done in the MRI suite. We use the MRI imaging to locate our target and to direct that energy. And we actually use the MRI machine to measure the heat signature generated by those sound waves. So there are multiple aspects of this procedure which allow us to really fine-tune the procedure so that we get an immediate effect. And so in the MRI scanner, we're doing the focus ultrasound treatment, and then we will take a break and come in and actually assess the patient's exam. We can have them holding something, we can have them drawing spirals. And so when we do a treatment and we expect to see a result, we can test for that result immediately. And when the symptoms are markedly better, then we know that we're right where we need to be. And in the case of this procedure, it's an outpatient procedure. Folks come into the hospital and they go home the same day. For many people who have essential tremors, they will tremor when they are trying to do things. So this can be very disabling because it involves activities. So for example, folks with essential tremor will tremor when they're trying to write or when they're using a keyboard, when they're trying to eat or drink. So holding a cup of coffee or water, it may spill just because the hand is shaking so much. Food may fall off the fork or the spoon, and it can be very difficult to do some simple tasks. Essential tremors are traditionally treated with prescription medication when they become disabling or bothersome to an individual. And these medications can be very helpful, but also are limited in terms of the number of options we have and the potential for side effects. Generally speaking, they will have already tried all the reasonable medications and been through the care of a neurologist or a movement disorder specialist like myself to make sure that they have exhausted all the non-surgical medication treatment options. The impact on tremor is significant. The potential for a substantial improvement in tremor is very high, much better than what we see with prescription medications, so the potential benefits are very good. There are some potential risks of the procedure. There's risk that it could cause some change in speech or a little bit of slurring of the speech, or that it could cause a little bit of imbalance. It's not uncommon for folks to have some very mild symptoms like that immediately after the procedure, and after a few days, those symptoms will get much better. For our patients with tremors, their tremors are having a significant impact on their quality of life. And it's really amazing to be able to start the day dealing with a bothersome symptom, and to go through a procedure like this that doesn't involve any incisions, and at the end of the day, the tremor is so much better that you can feed yourself, that you can hold a bottle of water, that you can draw on a piece of paper and write your name without any difficulty. And that smile that we see on the patient's face is really what makes this job worthwhile.